I just fuck your bitch with some Gucci flip flops.
Heartthrob never, black and ugly as ever. However, I stay Gucci down to the socks.
You get the bag and fumble it, I get the bag and flip it and tumble it.
Tashawn B.
And you are now tuned in to the coziest talk here. Now look. Let me say this first.
We here.
Before we pay bills, before we talk to our family, because this, we y'all our family now. Y'all here.
Yes, sir.
We let y'all in the layer. We let y'all in the coziest layer you ever see. So before we talk to the family, now look, this was our dilemma, right? So we don't allow our family to have a part in this. So our dilemma was, what song would signify such a monument, such a momentous occasion? Like this is monumental. This is grand, right? So we debated a few songs. Now these songs don't have a time stamp on them.
Timeless songs.
Timeless classics.
I repeat, they are timeless classics.
So we hope that. Now, matter of fact, y'all gonna comment. Right.
And let us know.
And let us know what we need to turn up to. Because we debate, right? Okay, so we're just gonna play a few clips and we're gonna let y'all let us know what y'all want.
And next week,
we rockin' with you. I used to have nothing, but now I got a whole lot of everything. Got a couple of stuff, and now the whole world gon' know my name. And I used to have nothing, but now I got a whole lot of everything. That's why I come through stuntin'. When I'm gone, the whole world gon' know my name. 12 years old, caught up in that shit.
That's the first one. What you think?
What you gonna give him with? I mean,
what you think? Of course, right?
That's, okay. Hey, that's the snowman. I rock with it.
Okay, so this is what we're gonna do. The next one. Now this is a fan favorite. This is a song that signifies a lot of people's stories. So it's a cliche, I would say, but
it's a classic.
It's
definitely a classic. Definitely a classic.
Nonetheless, and. It signifies everything. So whether you've already even if you've been at the bottom, even if you actually started there,
because a lot of people claim they did.
Even if you actually started there, you didn't. Your bottom is really different than somebody else's bottom. We just started, but look how lavish we are. Look how lavish we are.
You can start. It just depends on how you start. You feel me?
Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team fucking here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Nigga, started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Nigga, started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team fucking here. I done kept it real from the jump.
Damn. I got plenty more for him. But what we gonna do now, we're gonna kick this thing off. First thing first, let's pay the bills.
Ooh, okay.
Let's pay the bills. Okay.
We need a roof over our head.
Now, this first episode of Flip Flops and Socks is brought to you by the Quo Group. Quo Group. Now look, if you live in Chicago, I'm positive.
You know who this man is.
You know who Quo is.
For sure.
You know who Quo is. And if you don't, let
for
me
for sure.
You. This guy's a motivator.
He's an innovator.
He's an entrepreneur. A CEO.
Started from the bottom.
Truly started from the bottom.
Yes, sir.
And I'll say this. Philanthropy. from parties to public speaking, from bar mitzvahs to bat mitzvahs. I'm talking about the most lavish upscale events in Chicago. The most lavish and upscale events in Chicago. This man, Kareem Wells, and I'll tell you this, I'm gonna say this. This is what's gonna fuck you up right here. The man throws the most lavish and upscale bar mitzvahs and parties and corporate events and weddings and anything you can think of. The man is black.
Let's give him his flowers while he's alive.
The man is black. He's a black CEO. I see you like that, baby. I see you, baby. That's what I like to hear now.
Show that love, baby.
Now, he's all of those things, and guess what he is now? He's a sponsor for the Flip Flops and Socks podcast.
Let's give him a round of applause.
We got to give him a round of applause. He made a lot of this shit possible, so we got to show love for our sponsor. Now,
shout out to Quo.
Now, before we hop on into that thing, we got to make sure we show love. Because my mom always raised me. Never go anywhere and be in. When you show somebody house, don't go and be in.
Yes, sir. Any cookout you go to, make sure you bring some water. Make sure you bring some paper towels, paper plates, something. They won't even use it. Just bring it. You don't want to be that guy.
You don't want
to be that woman.
You don't.
Period.
So when we came, we came bearing gifts. We came bearing gifts. I mean, by the way, this is not Hennessy. So, y'all, this is not Hennessy. Okay? I don't know what y'all see. This isn't Hennessy because we're not sponsored by Hennessy yet.
At all.
Hennessy all of us. Anyway, we got Bix, baby. We got custom flip-flops and socks. Bix five. First.
One 50, flick.
One, it's a one flick Bix.
One flick.
Now, that's for the first 50 people that subscribe,
50?
I'm talking about you can go do it right now. Click the button.
Click the button.
Comment,
please,
flip
hurry.
When you're done. We're going to get it to them with you ASAP. And we're going to get your light up to you.
And make sure ASAP. You get it. And make sure you let us know that you got it.
You got to send us a picture. Let us know that you got it because we're going to get it to you.
Please, because we definitely going to show you love.
We're going to show you love. But again.
Thank you in advance.
The only way to be eligible to get one of these free lights. I'm talking about this is a cut. Come on now. This custom. This is not a crackhead lighter. This
First
is not
off.
A crackhead lighter, fam. This ain't with the flame.
This
you
is not
adjust.
A 50 cent lighter.
Come on, man. Once you strike it 80 times to get one strike, your thumb is raw.
You
man.
Only need one.
Your thumb is
ooh,
raw.
A raw thumb.
Ooh. A raw.
Oh, it my God. Tender.
It's so tender.
Ooh. Tender. Winter.
All of that to get high.
Ooh, make me look at my thumb right now,
bro. Yeah, I'm
brought back memories when you were a kid because you didn't know no better.
You didn't know no better. So upgrade your life because you do know better now. And get your custom bit. Again, subscribe. Go to the comments, comment
flip,
the first 50 people. But, I know what you're thinking. What, the light is after 50? If I don't make it after the 50, I can't get it. But you can. Mm-hmm. Oh, you can. You can get your hands on one of these lighters. I'm letting my
all you people. Have to do is go on to flipflopsocks.com. Okay. And not only can you get a lighter, you can get your springtime and your summertime wear. All the way from rain jackets, flip-flops, and socks, custom-made. Man, we got more to come. But oh, just
yeah. So we got more than just t-shirts and hoodies.
And hold on. Wait a minute. Since y'all the fam, not only are we looking out for y'all, we're going to give y'all 10% off. All you have to do is enter flip 10 at the end of your purchase. That's flip 10 at the end of your purchase.
All right, hold on now. The yak getting to you because we just gave away. But you know what? That was my
see, gift. See, this is
okay.
The thing.
Okay,
you got to remember.
We're not
this
selfish.
Is the fam,
this
baby.
This is the family we're talking about.
This is the fam.
So what's the website again?
Flipflopsocks.com and enter flip 10 at the end of your purchase for that 10% off.
I'm gonna get 10% off all the merchandise. Everything.
I'm only gonna repeat it one time. What's understood don't have to be explained.
Okay.
The family know what's up.
Okay. Okay. Now I got a question.
Yes, sir.
I got, well, not even a question. I actually do have a question. Bro, what the fuck is wrong with Chicago?
Mm-hmm. We do
what the fuck is wrong with Chicago?
We do what we want. Cause,
wait,
that's how we roll.
Okay, so wait, wait. Now, bro, the other day, bro, it was warm outside. I'm riding out. Granted, I was riding, but I had errands to ride, things I actually had to do. I wasn't just outside kicking.
Okay.
Bro, with so many motherfuckers outside when it was that 70 degree day, bro, the other day. And now, look, now look, this lady. Bro, now, matter of fact, let me look at the camera and tell them this. Hold on, can I drink this?
I'm going to tell you one thing.
Can I drink this?
Please.
Can I drink this real quick? Because I got it.
Please. But I'm going to tell you one thing. Mm-hmm. Chicago is a city that does what it wants. Mm-hmm. I'm going to tell you that now. And that's why I love my city.
I see, right? Now, let me tell you this. If you keep doing what you want, if you keep doing what you want, now this lady been told y'all. Let me tell you something, bro. Look, Lightfoot, oh, she gonna put a heavy foot off in y'all ass, y'all keep playing with. She's gonna put, oh, she's a heavy stepper.
Hey, big heavy stepper.
She's a heavy stepper.
She look like, but it's heavy though. And I'm telling you this right now.
Like the motherfucking material them suits, man. No, heavy.
She's well affiliated, so stop playing with her.
Oh, she one of them.
Stop playing with her.
She one of them ones. So again,
man,
let me tell you this. If you keep fucking with this lady, okay, for the people who don't know, Lori Lightfoot is the mayor in Chicago.
Yes.
She's had so many press conferences. Shout out to Lori Lightfoot. She's had so many press conferences begging the people of Chicago to stay indoors. Motherfuckers still, I'm talking about, it's 2020. My buddy's still doing PPs.
Baby.
My buddy's still doing PPs.
Come on.
They're talking PPs back, bro. Oh, my life, I'm getting guay. Come on, bro.
Hey, come on. Hey, I'm about to try to do the old block, but I ain't gonna
put it right. No.
I ain't gonna do it.
You might get a heavy foot in your ass if she catches you doing it. That's the thing. Because the only way you can do the old bop is if you go in the middle of the
street. If you go in the middle of the street,
that's
right
the
now.
Only way. We're going to have to take these cap every all this. All
look, the whole equipment go outside.
Everything got to go with us just to capture this. But all I'm saying is this. Chicago. Come on, let's stay indoors. Let's stay safe for the quarantine.
Please.
We're going to be y'all guys. Y'all can rock with us for the quarantine. If you feel like you got to go outside, just turn on flip-flops and socks.
And get cozy.
Make
sure you cozy.
This is the cozy podcast. And come on, man. Let's hold. Okay, first, hold on. You got the socks on.
Mm-hmm.
You got your flip flop.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you got this chair. What is this? What is this chair attached to? I don't know, but I feel like I'm floating.
It's attached to coziness. Okay.
I'm glad y'all still tuned in. Can I stop being nice now? Can I stop? Can I please stop being nice?
I mean, if you're not gonna be nice, then I hope you're gonna be real.
Okay, cause look.
Are you gonna be real?
I'm gonna be real.
Okay, that's how much.
Bro, look, I've been waiting to pop my shit. This is the whole reason this came about, bro. I've been waiting to pop my shit, bro.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so look, bro. Now, this is some shit.
Man.
I wasn't even supposed to bring this up, mm-hmm. my boy. But I have to, bro, because I had this conversation just the other day, bro.
America. Listen.
He enjoys thoroughly.
Listen.
The escapades that I bring to him.
Listen. Just get cozy.
Okay, so I hope, first of all.
Just get cozy.
I hope you got your flip flops and I hope you got your socks on.
Just get cozy.
See, these right here, these custom. You can get these on the website.
Yes, sir.
You can make your own.
Yes, sir.
Custom name. Oh, look, the name. Oh, the name. You got lyrics. Oh, oh. Come on.
Catch the view.
Come on. Now, anyway.
Catch the view.
I'm done with all that shit. Bro, I'm chilling the other day.
Talk to the fam, bro.
I'm chilling the other day, bro. I'm chilling with some peers of mine. It's a nice ratio of us.
Mm-hmm.
it's about nine of us. It's about five women and four men.
Okay.
And we're talking about, you know, all the things that young black people talk about. Love, life, relationships, dating, finances, all of the above.
Children.
Oh, come on. Everything. We talk about it all. And I just remember we was on a conversation of dating and like, I guess more than dating, relationships, things getting serious. And I feel like the conversation got derailed.
And I feel like. The more I listened, all I heard was I started hearing this. I don't give a fuck what he do. He could be the best man I ever had. If you ain't bringing no ring, kick rocks. I'm letting it go. I'm like, damn, that sounded weird. Okay, cool. 2 seconds later, he motherfucker gonna marry me at the end of the day. A motherfucker gonna marry me. I say, whoa,
that's kind of harsh.
A mother lover.
That's
a mother.
Kinda, that's kind of harsh.
Flipper.
Okay. Continue. I'm sorry. Let me let you finish.
A mother flipper's going to marry you? I'm talking about from the context clues of the conversation, this man's clearly doing everything that a woman would want. And more. And I kept saying, okay, because I kept hearing, oh, because he gonna marry me. I'm gonna make sure I'm happy and all these things. And I'm like, okay, cool. So I started thinking like, Well, I'm not, I never claimed to be the smartest man in the world, my boy. I never claimed to be the smartest man in the world, my boy.
Yes, sir. But.
But, you know what's a but?
But.
But I do have Google, bro. I do have the internet. Like everybody else. And.
All you got to do is hit that button.
That search button. Now, I asked, I said, okay, let me see. Let me make sure the stats are still the same. And they were. And, they were.
What were they? And what were the stats that you looked up?
The stats were that 50% of all marriages end in divorce. 50. That's half, bro.
And it hasn't changed? Like, hold on, like.
Wait, no, look. After all these years, the numbers is still staggering, right? I'm sorry. These Invisaligns. Anyway, we're going to get through this. Now, I said, okay, so if 50, going by that logic, 50% of all marriages end in divorce. So going by that logic, marriage doesn't automatically equate to happiness, obviously, if half of all marriages end in divorce.
Or true love.
Oh, we're gonna get, I got something to tell you about that too. Now,
I'm that little troll under the bridge.
The troll under the bridge. Now look. Okay, so I had to, this, they forced me by saying these, making these statements that they made, they forced me to ask the question. Is the end goal happiness? Or is the end goal marriage?
Ooh, I'm thirsty to hear this.
Wait. Go ahead.
I'm thirsty to hear this. Because at the end of the day, women want what they want. So I'm just gonna let you hear. I'm just gonna let you finish.
Okay. Now, I said, now they all, they look, they say both. You know what everybody, same thing y'all saying at home who watching right now. Both. I want both. Both is my end. Okay. Now, in a perfect world where there are cotton candy trees.
And unicorns.
and fucking unicorns and, bro, rainbows galore.
You could have whatever you want.
You could have both.
T.I., whatever you like.
But in but in this world, the facts are, the stats say half of all marriages end with people not being happy. That's why the marriage ended. So I beg this question. Matter of fact, so when I asked them that, I got some murmurs. I got, wait, both? And I said, okay, in a perfect world, cool. So is the end goal marriage or happiness? And it took them a second to respond. And I'm like, okay, cool. You know, I was just wondering. Like, I'm not judging or nothing. I just wanted to know because I'm curious.
He's curious, y'all.
So I'm curious, bro. Now, I say, okay, well, let me break it down for y'all like this. This is how I gave it to him. I said, let me break it down for y'all like this then. Let me give you a scenario. Before you answer, let me give you a scenario. Since you said marriage is a deal breaker, marriage is the end all, be all. You bet you're going to marry me? You're going to marry me?
Or it's nothing.
You could be or that and all of the above, but if you're not trying to put a ring on his finger at the end of the day, this hand. Kick rocks. So I said, let me give you this scenario. You got a guy. You got a guy, right? Now this guy's handsome. This woman, she got this guy. This guy is handsome. He's charismatic. He's affectionate, caring,
attentive.
Woo! Financially stable.
Oh my God!
Come on now. Let's build him.
He's 6 feet. He's over 6 feet.
He's nice to your mom. Your mom loves him. I'm talking about.
You can't love nobody if they don't love your mom.
Oh my God. I'm talking about, bro, this is the perfect guy. He's ambitious. He's all of these things that you would want in a man.
And he's probably good to your kids.
Matter of fact, let's do this one. You don't even have kids. Even if you do, he's good to them. But if you don't, he's this type of guy. He doesn't have kids either. And you know what? He wants to give you babies, and he wants to be the best father to your children. Not only does he want to be good to you in your lifetime, he wants to be good to your offspring. I mean,
he's a man of a man.
He's a man of all men, right?
He's a hunk.
and throughout the time of you getting to know this young man or old man or whatever age you are, it doesn't matter. This is Mr. Perfect. Whatever if he a silver fox and he an older guy, cool. If he a young guy with a little weak fade with the and look, if he one of them. Cool.
Hats goes off to him.
Hats to him. Whoever he is that's perfect to you, cool. So he's that guy. over the course of getting to know this guy, right? I asked him, I said, you fall in love with this man. He's a hell of a guy. You fall in love with him. But he tells you, hey, baby, let me tell you something. You are the most incredible woman I've ever met in my life. And I'm going to tell you right now, I'll be everything to you and more. I'm talking about I will move heaven and earth. I will, I'll pop to see if you need me to. But one thing,
I hunt a damn bear if you want me to.
Help the bear! If you're like into a fight with a bear, help the bear!
Because I'm going to be the one causing pain.
For you, he will. Whitney Houston. So, he tells you this, though. One thing I can't do is marry you. I cannot, and I shan't.
I'm going to tell you this right now. How simple that sounds to you, that's a stab in the back
to that young
every woman in America.
Okay, so now let me say this. He tells her this, but he's not this willy-nilly just.
Loose goose.
Come lately. He's not that guy. He's this guy. He's the guy that says, but I have a reason for it. And you say, you're all ears. I'm telling these, the women we talk. Now, mind you, it's not just the women. It's dudes in this conversation, four right. guys in this conversation. And two of these guys.
Now, what was their feedback? Do you remember?
That's what I said. They were actually on the side of the women. They were like, no, marriage is the end goal and all that. So I'm not just putting it on the women. So for all the people watching, it's not just, I'm just curious.
Men out here that want to get married too as well.
I'm just curious. I just want to know. I like learning. So. The dudes was the same way, whatever, cool. Well, half of them, 2 and 2. So, he says, I have a reason. My parents took me through the most traumatic experience with their divorce. The most traumatic. This is a scenario.
And he's not the only one. It's a lot of people in the world who family deal with divorce.
Yeah.
But people choose not to face that. But continue.
So, he says... This experience was traumatizing, man. When I was young, they were so in love. And I remember them saying, we're going to get married. You're gonna be involved. Your younger sister, she's going to be the flower girl. It's going to be a whole thing. And it's like after that day, when they came back from the honeymoon, it was like they were different people. It's like they started to fall out of love. And I'm not going to say it was because of the actual marriage. But I just started to realize that after this happened, things changed. Things changed. So, I would never want that for us.
And the key and the goal is happiness. And I'm trying to avoid that.
I'm trying to avoid being unhappy, which is divorce. So I want to keep this happiness that we have. I was so traumatized by it. This is why I have such strong feelings towards it. So this is his reason. This is what I'm telling them. Now they look like, I'm going to feed you, baby birds.
Feed them.
I'm going to feed you, baby birds. I'm going to feed you. Don't worry, because I want to make sure.
That you understand.
Because I want to understand. The only way that I can understand is if you understand. So. This guy, he tells you all these things, and he says, "So I'll do it. I'll be the man. Let me even put all this in the atmosphere too. He doesn't cheat.
Black men don't cheat anyway.
Well, black men don't cheat anyway, and of course, this man is black or whatever race that you need him to be for this scenario.
That's perfect for you.
But black men, just for the record,
black men don't cheat.
Skrilla. Black men don't cheat." Oh, if you
why
can see
will
it,
we? Why will we?
He wants to rip his shirt over like Superman and a shirt that say black men.
Black men don't cheat under.
That says black men don't cheat.
Why would we?
It's a fact. So. I might have to go on the trippy box.
The box is not there for no reason, young man.
Okay, wait, not yet. Let me finish the story. Because the trippy box. I'm getting low on my trippiness as well. Now. So this guy, he tells you all these things. He tells you how traumatic it was for him. And he tells you, I'll be the man of your dreams, the man you want me to be. I won't cheat. I won't do you wrong. I won't lie. I won't hurt you. None of these things. I won't do any of these things. What I'll do is be the best man you've ever seen. But I cannot marry you. Can you get with that? Now, this is the scenario. That's him, right? And then you got guy number two. So he's offering you happiness. And then you got guy number two. Guy number two, he's not as handsome.
He's not as sly.
Oh, he's not as charismatic. He's not as ambitious. He's not as financially stable.
He's not attentive. He's not affectionate.
Now, the reason this is this hypothetical scenario is because we don't live in a perfect world. Mm. In a perfect world, that the guy number one, he would want to marry. He would say, yeah, I'll get married. Let's do it. Perfect. It's not the world
that we live in.
Perfect. The statistics say otherwise. So let's go with the stats. Let's go with the facts.
We're going with numbers. Numbers don't lie.
Let's go with the facts. Let's go with the facts. So, guy number two isn't ambitious. He's a run-of-the-mill guy. He's your average guy. Your average run-of-the-mill Joe. He's not the guy that makes you.
Is he your average blue collar?
You don't. I mean, whatever collar he is, he doesn't make you feel the way that guy number one would.
Mm.
That feeling. Guy number one gives you that feeling.
Mm. So those goosebumps.
I get those goosebumps every time. Okay, so.
I get that.
So. But you know what guy number two will do?
He'll marry you.
Oh, he'll marry you, bro. He will marry you, and in a heartbeat, he will. Right? So, I only gave you the scenario to work all of that out to ask this question. I gotta ask this question, bro. So, if guy number one is offering you everything and more, but he's saying because of his own reasons, oh, let me throw this in there for all of my religious folks out there, this is a God-fearing man in your scenario.
Mm.
He tells you, because I know what you're thinking.
And he goes to church.
Because that's the first thing they was going to say. Well, if he's a man of God,
he would already
know. Okay, so let me explain to you this. So we can include, be all, everybody, I want everybody to have their scenario where it's like, no ways out. He's a God-fearing man, and he expresses to you deeply, deeply, hey, I know that the book says man, woman, married, matrimony. I know that's what the book says.
Hmm.
And I fight my own internal battles every day as a man.
Because I know I'm going against that word.
I'm going against it.
Hmm.
But you know why I feel so? Because I saw it rip my parents apart, and it's something in me.
Hmm.
So I would never want that to happen to us. And I face these battles every day.
Hmm.
I'm coming to you as a man. Facing these battles every day.
He pouring out his heart.
He pouring his heart. Nah, come on, man. Come on. Can we talk to the man? Skrilla, come on, Skrilla.
You got
a drink?
He's so pure. I pulled up a can of the dry. You hear me?
Come on, man.
Holy moly.
This is the guy.
Guacamole.
This is the guy.
Shit.
Come on, man. God damn. Now. So.
Jeez.
He poured out his heart.
Jeez.
So that's guy number one. Guy number two, of course, we said all that. Not as ambitious, obviously, but he'll marry you. So guy number one is offering you happiness. Guy number two is offering you
marriage.
I give you marriage, but I won't be the most faithful man. I'm just a man.
Mm.
Guy number one is like, hey, look, he's telling you, I'll do anything for you. I'll do the best I can. I'm just a man. Guy number one is like, hey, I'm just a nigga.
What you expect?
What you expect? So.
I mean, hey, I'll be here for the family.
So. Oh, my God. When I can. So. When I can. When it's convenient.
I was about to say something, but I couldn't even say nothing. Because that's it.
A fact.
That's fact.
Now, I ask this question to you after all of this. I ask this question, bro. I got to ask this question. Would you rather be unhappily married? Now let's do it this way, because guy number one, we want to give guy number one his respect.
Yes.
Would you rather be happily unmarried?
Ooh, he fixed that. He fixed that and put so much conviction.
I'm talking about happily unmarried or unhappily married, because guy number two is not going to make you happy. You know he's telling you this. I'm not going to be the most faithful guy. I'm not going to be the best dad. Come on, the game's
honestly,
on.
He don't have to tell you that. This is kind of like something that you know
this about him.
You want to get married.
You want to get married that bad.
And you think you can change him.
Right? So would you rather be? I want to know. Please comment, and we're going to make sure we cover this.
Please. Because.
Would you rather be?
I'm going to read off some of the best. I'm sorry. I'm going to read off some of them comments.
Okay.
I'm not going to lie to you, because I really want to know.
Bro, I can't wait. Y'all better go bananas in the comments. Would you rather be happily unmarried or unhappily married. In this scenario, I understand in a perfect world, you'd be, I want to be both. I want to be happily married.
In a perfect world, you're a princess.
All those 50% fail marriages, they wanted to be happily married too. I'm just playing devil's advocate. Not even devil's advocate. I'm just playing advocate because I don't really like how that sounds. So I'm just being a guy that's trying to figure out what's going on. Mm-hmm.
And from his point of view, we just want answers. From both our point of view, we just want answers.
Man, bro.
We just want answers.
I'm just trying to get an understanding. So y'all make sure y'all go bananas in the comments. Y'all make sure y'all help us understand. Because I'm going to say this. If I would, matter of fact, I got to go on a trippy.
Because I feel that it's getting deep right now. Let me get in there. Let me get in there.
Hey, bro, you saw that monster.
You see how fast I move, right? It might look slow, but it felt fast to me.
Bro, don't fuck around.
Shit.
Don't you fuck around now.
Shit.
Don't you fuck around.
He was hiding all the goodies anyway.
Bro, don't fuck around. Now.
He was hiding all the goodies now, anyway.
Because I have to ask this. Well, not even ask this. I want to say this. If you choose, because I only ask the question so that I can get answers. And I like to think ahead about what I would say or how I would feel if you give me these certain answers. So if the answer was, oh, fuck that, the end goal is marriage. Well, forget that. The end goal is marriage. The end goal is marriage. I don't care. I'm going to still get married. That shows you don't even really want happiness.
Hold on. You don't even value your man's opinion on anything. You don't even value how he feels. You don't even value his feelings. Because shit.
And I understand.
For you to choose, I mean, you know what? That's not my place.
No. You know what? It's not your place. But you know what's crazy, bro? In a sense, it is. Because let's keep it real. Coming from men, if you pour your heart out like guy number one did, you poured your heart out to this woman, man. And the first thing she says is, ring. Ring anyone. And you and that bitch like, so all of my things I bought you, I made sure I helped you get your business started. I made sure all of these things that you
got
wanted,
you that new car.
I'm just so humble. I'm just a humble, handsome guy. I could be a model part time.
If I wanna.
But what I do in my part time is I read to old people. And for a living, oh, I save cats from trees. I'm Superman.
And I build things for you.
For you. I built your house from bare from the ground up. So y'all better go fucking bananas, because bro, this is.
Because I'm not gonna lie to you. I really want to know, because I'm like guy number one. I'm gonna make sure all your needs are fulfilled. But why do we need to go through that situation so you can fake feel for like happiness? Like I mean, just understand where I'm coming from.
Facts.
Just understand where I'm coming from.
What you want? The visuals, you want the dress, you want the ring.
I understand where I'm coming from.
You want to be able to say, oh, I got married. And I understand a lot of people say, oh, it's family's tradition. Well, my family tradition. You know what's crazy, bro? I asked. There's only one. Now, I'm not going to say this was the whole crowd. I asked. These Invisaligns make it difficult. But we're going to get it done. So I asked. I said, okay. If it's, it was the girl, she said, this is family tradition. I said, if it's, your parents are married? She said, yes. Married. I said, are they happily married? What you mean? I said, on a scale from 1 to 10, how happy would you say your parents are? Do you know what she told me? And I kid you not.
10.
No. 4. A 4. And you know what she said? But that's real love, because they working it out and sticking it out. I'd rather leave you and be happy at a 5 with somebody else. Let's let each other go so we can at least be a 6 with somebody else. A 4 with you for the rest of my life? That's love?
That's not even close to above average.
Bro, I know love ain't perfect, but damn, if that's what I'm destined for, I'm not saying it's all marriages. So for people who marry who happy, more power to you. Comment and let us know what keeps
that
your marriage going.
That y'all are happy.
What keeps your marriage going? Let us know. So, because, bro, look, I'm not married.
It's only a question. And it's only a question. Remember that. It's only a question.
Come on,
and a scenario.
So don't eat us. I'm just the messenger.
Messenger guy.
I didn't want to bring this up. But you get the oil in you. You know how it goes. Oh, the bottle was blessed before we started filming, just so y'all know.
Oh yeah. We still bless bottles around.
Come on, man.
Yes, sir.
The bottle was blessed now.
Yes, sir.
And
this is not Hennessy, by the way.
I don't know. This is not Hennessy. I don't know what y'all see on this label right here, this label here, but that does not say Hennessy.
Nope.
Until we get a sponsor, and then it'll say whatever the sponsor wants it to say. Skrilla, you good back there? Cause okay, just making sure we gotta make. Come on, man, this guy's working. Everybody in the studio is working so hard.
See,
right now, man,
hardest working man in America.
Jesus Christ! But Skrilla, he's a cut above the rest. Mm. Now, I didn't want to bring this up, bro, but we getting trippy. Well, let me put them down so they, because they want to. Because
that monster,
they are salivating. You gotta put them away. They're salivating over the lighters. I hope they're salivating over the lighters. I hope they're like, oh, I need one of those lighters. Because the thing is, you can be getting high in no time.
And they flick what?
Just subscribe.
Oh my God! They flick once. They flick once.
But they don't even know that these are pill and reveals. Mm. But they'll figure that out when they get them a pill and reveal. You gonna see? Just temper. Just
see. I didn't even know.
Just fiddle with
that. It was a pill and like this don't, is look. Just hold on. Wait a minute.
Okay.
Wait a minute. You mean to tell me I take this label off? It's something under here. This ain't no plain lighter.
It's your own personal. I mean, look, it's a Bic, man. I want you guys to, if you don't want this logo, if you like, you know, I don't care. I like the show, but I don't care for the logo, pill and reveal. That's all I'm saying, and I won't give you no more. So, I didn't want to bring this up, but because we was in the yeah, I know, bro. I just try to stay innovative, bro.
I really didn't know nothing about this. I was trying to stay innovative,
but I want to say this, bro. I want to say this because we running low on time, too. So, I want to say this. And we probably gonna have to finish this on the next one, but we're gonna get into it right now. Fuck that. So one of the girls that was there, she was she was, I'll say, remember I said it was five women, so I'll say it was two and two. Because the fifth woman, she didn't really have a take on it. This was a woman of the BBW persuasion.
Mm, okay.
She was lovely.
Mm.
Gorgeous.
Mm.
Beautiful.
Mm. Mm. Scrumdiddlyumptious.
Some would say big boned and all these other mean things that
I say healthy.
That rookies would. I gotta get this out, bro. I got to. I'm sorry. I know, bro. This is the thing. I know they want to hear from you. Mm. I know they want to hear from you.
But see, this is my thing.
But I gotta talk to you like they not even here. Because you know when we talk, I gotta come and I say, bro, tell me if I'm losing my mind. Tell me, bro. If I'm losing my mind.
And this is what I'm usually here for.
Okay.
I get my feedback when my feedback is needed.
I love it. Now, she didn't have a say so either way on the topic. She said marriage, whatever. And I said, you've been kind of quiet. Oh, but what's your take? She said, I don't have a pen either way. I say, why? She said, well, married or not married or whatever. I'll tell you right now, until the day I'm ready to do what I want to do. Mm. She's showing me as this big healthy woman showing me she's in control at this point.
I mean, because she very much sounds like she's in control.
She's in control at this point. Now, I don't have no control over the situation at this point. She's in control. She's reading me.
I'm very
she's
intrigued
reading me my
right
rights.
Now. I don't know if y'all can see this right now. Look. I'm very intrigued right
she's
now.
Reading me my rights. She says, when I'm ready to think about that and decide that, I'll come up with a decision and I'll have an answer. Until then, I'm going to continue to do what I want to do, which is get any man that I want.
Wait, she told you straight like that?
Bro, look. I'm going to continue to do what I want to do because I can get any man. And I said, you know what?
They missed over the first word that you even said, continue. Baby, she's been doing her thing.
She's been doing her thing. She's been that in the game.
She's been doing her thing.
See, the thing is, the tone that this woman had, she showed me she was a vet in the game. She was a vet because, you know, I like to talk with, you know, a veteran tone sometimes. You know, you got to talk with that tone.
You got to flaunt your feathers. You know, when you're a peacock, you got to flaunt your feathers, baby.
So I said, okay, now I'm curious. So now we on another topic, you know, as we switch topics and, we talking. Now, of course, the other women are still, they still stuck on, wait, hold on. So do I actually want, and you know what I'm going to tell them? I'm gonna hit my homie up and I'm going to tell him to put us in a group message so I can tell them, hey, just comment in the box.
Because they're going to
give you some advice.
Yeah,
they're going to give you some advice. Mm-hmm. Let them know who you are. Let them know that you were at C said facility we were talking at, we were speaking at, let them know you were involved. So back to this lady. So she says, this big fine woman says this, to me.
All facts.
These are, and look, right. True story. You know what's funny, bro? We had a conversation about this. I forgot we had a conversation about this. I don't know if you remember, but we was talking about.
We have a lot of conversations.
We was challenge. Talking about how.
Boy,
we was talking about how, bro. Matter of fact, perfect. This leads me into
the perfect segue,
bro. You know I'm up with like big girls need love. Big girls don't need love.
They been getting love, baby.
Big
they
girls been, don't need no. Fuck.
They been getting love.
Bro, come on, who? Bro,
well, if you know, if you know what's really fucking going on,
bro, can we keep it a buck?
You know what the fuck going on for real?
Can we keep it real?
Big girls, and I don't mean, and I feel weird. And I feel weird just saying big girls because it's just like I don't want to single y'all out.
So what you want to call them, bro? What would you? In the comments, let us know.
Tall them healthy women out there.
The proper name for all these healthy, fine women.
Ooh.
You might not want to be called a big girl. You might want to be called a little mama. And I'm going to call you little mama. If you tell me that that's the consensus of the BBW community, y'all going to call us little mama from now on. Because before Lizzo, bro, way before Lizzo,
oh my
big girls
life.
Was getting
oh
love.
My, oh my, oh my. Bro.
Bro.
Big hey. Girls been getting love. And hey. that's an untold story, but you know what?
Bro, that's a... Skrilla, you got... Look at Skrill in the back.
Cause he like, Skrill, man, man, look.
We know the truth, baby. We gonna bring you the truth. We gonna feed you, baby birds. We gonna feed you, baby birds.
Boy, I have forgot. Hey, look, listen here.
Talk to me. Cause they make it seem like. Talk to me, bro.
Like I said, what's understood don't have to be explained. But fair. Big fair. Girls being. Getting love.
I hated that saying when I first heard it.
Big girls need love too.
Trying to make
it
seem
that shit.
Bro, hold on. First of all, if we can keep it a buck, can we keep it? Big girls is the reason why half of y'all relationships is still even intact.
Facts. And that's.
As you can see, this healthy woman, this healthy fine woman said, "I'm going to continue." Meaning she's been doing it. So. She has multiple options. We going through the conversation. She giving me the game. She letting me know, like, and I told her, you know what, baby? I didn't doubt you for one.
I ain't even mad.
I didn't doubt you for 1 second. Now, she said, oh, and when I'm done with you, I'm gonna send you back to your woman. Because majority of them got, because this fake ass embarrassed thing where it's like, I gotta make sure I got that. Bro. Shorty with that bogus ass weave on your arm do not look better than that big fine woman right there. So the fact that you still, even in your mind, are thinking trying to tell yourself, bro.
That and I mean, I'm over here inside because a lot of guys play themselves, bro. And it's like, bro, how can you be a 100 nigga, bro, and you literally out here playing these games and you're not even keeping it real with yourself when you know damn well, bro, when you with that woman, bro, you making her feel damn near better than your bitch. Let's just keep it real. And I don't mean to be disrespectful. That's just what it is.
I'm just going
to
leisurely swing.
That's just what it is. And I ain't going to stunt. As more episodes to come, you're going to understand where I'm coming from.
Bro. I'll trust me.
What's understood don't have to be explained.
Trust me, bro. I can guarantee you to understand because I'm sitting here and I'm wondering. You know what it is, though? The niggas who do that type of shit, who act like, oh, I'm embarrassed to be around this certain type of girl. And that, bro, if you fucking with her and you doing what you do, bro. Now, if it's just a little, you know, little throwback stanky, you just. You glad.
A throwback stanky.
You glad, a little throwback stanky, something that you just, you know, you glad and slide and you ain't really trying to do too much. But if you going over there and that woman is feeding you, that woman is lacing you, she's taking, at her expense.
Hold on.
She's at her
going,
leisure.
She's going out her way out her asking way. You, have you ate?
Your own girl at home ain't asked you, have you ate? Have you eaten?
How are you?
Have you eaten?
How's your day? And you giving a full conversation, but you out here pump faking for
the
world.
You know why you pump faking? Because he was a fucking gump
from the jump.
Bro, the nigga was a gump from the jump. He was a gump from the jump, bro. And you know why? And also, I'll tell you this too. You know what else he was, bro? The nigga was too lame. He was too lame to claim,
baby. Too lame.
I'm glad you know.
To claim.
Look, I'm glad we could bring y'all. The conversations that we have, bro, I'm so tired of niggas being gumps from the jump, bro. And y'all know.
Buford ass niggas, man, I'm sorry, bro. Y'all have to literally stay the fuck out the way. Because at the end of the day, this is 2020, bro. These women want the real, bro.
The real, bro.
They want the real, bro.
Stop
at the end of the day,
motherfuckers, man. Who show
they
you
harder
love,
than us
man.
Nowadays anyway.
Oh, yeah.
So once you keep, because at the end of the day, I'm gonna keep it real. I'm gonna go ahead and drop some jewels.
Okay.
And I hate this. I'm not even spinning the beans, but it just is what it is. If you're a real one and you're dealing with a bad one, you know she's dealing with more than one guy. And you have to be that real one to understand.
And by bad one,
she got it.
Big, tall, small, and all.
Yes, sir. A woman that's on her business.
That's on her shit.
Period.
All this fake ass physical shit. Bro, look. Look, bro. I'm so tired of niggas, bro. If you're too lame to claim, get out the way, my boy.
Yep. Simple as that.
Please get out
Simple
the way.
Simple as that.
Please get out the way. Now, just because I know they at home. I know they got home going, oh, you better tell them. So let me go on. Just end that out.
And we go tell them.
When I talked to her, I said, okay. So you're telling me, I just want to get this because I'm curious. I'm curious, George. I'm curious, George. And we gotta get out of here. We gotta get out of here in a second. We gotta get out of here in a second. But look at Skrilla. Like, no, bro.
Keep it rolling. They won't feed them.
Skrilla, we gonna feed
them. You told them we was gonna feed the baby birds.
But see, this is the thing. As soon as we try to feed them, Skrilla gonna be in the back. Like, all right, that's enough.
You giving them too much. You're overfeeding them.
You're overfeeding them. Skrilla in the back like this. Hold the phone. Hey, you remember the
operator. Hey, can you give me 6?
You remember this? Hello. Can I speak to Mr. Potter?
Please. Give me 6.
Motherfucker had 6 phones in the whole motherfucking county. The whole county. What number is this? This is 3. Hold on, you got the wrong number. Call 5.
Bro,
we're gonna feed you baby birds, but I do wanna end it. I do wanna end it. The segment with this young lady, because this is a big, healthy woman. And she kept it a buck, bro. So I just want, from now on, can we all just keep it a buck with everything?
That's all we ask.
And if you're looking at the girl right now, or you're looking through your phone and you're looking at your options, and you're looking at these are the women that I sex when you don't want to claim them, and you, that's the guy you are. That's the caliber of woman. That's what you got, buddy. Sorry.
That's what it is, bro. But just remember one thing. Keep it real with yourself.
Wear it
before you try to keep it real with somebody else.
Come on, man. Shambi.
Please.
Now, come on, man.
Please. That's all I ask. That's all the world asks.
Is that all you ask?
That's all. And I ask for y'all to go to flipflopsandsocks.com so y'all can get all of y'all spring and summer merchandise.
Wait, so is the website... See, now I'm trying to figure out, because we're going to have a link right down there. You know when people put the words and they at the bottom and then they say...
And just scroll
right
past. Just scroll past.
We click the... Well, I'm sure they're going to click because they got these lighters is waiting on them. And we got... Don't worry about it. Oh, we got give all. We got giveaways.
We're going to give...
Giveaway.
We're going to give... But it's not even Christmas.
Is it flipflopsocks.com?
Yes. Flipflopsocks.com.
So no and.
No and.
Just flip...
Flops...
Socks.
.com.
All right, man. Well...
We kicked it with the fam tonight.
We had family night. Bro,
we had family night. Can we continue to have family night?
Can we finish a little bit? Can I ask you one more thing?
I don't think they want to go home anyway.
It's quarantine. They ain't doing shit.
Y'all got time.
You ain't doing shit.
I got time today.
I got time today. We asked them. Mm-hmm. Now, all of this came off one conversation I had, bro. I had so much more I wanted to say to you. So much more. All of this came off one conversation.
And we will talk more.
Now, I want to say this, though. I got to ask you because I was sitting there, right, when we was playing these songs, and on my list, it was some artists popping up. I just want to give some to the people who like music and all these things. Bro, it's a lot of underrated artists in the fucking game. That were in the game. And I'm not talking about niggas who had one hit like Afro
That's
Man. Because
been
I got,
like
I'm, not, I'm
that
talking about
for
I'm
years.
Talking about motherfuckers who got real hits.
Genuine hits. Original flavor.
Overlooked, bro.
Original flavor.
And hey. Sometimes we was gumps from the jump too, cause why we all just hop on? I love 50, hey, cause that nigga's reckless. But bro, come on, bro.
Don't say his name in vain. That's like saying Candyman. don't say his name in vain. 50.
If you look in the mirror and say 50 three times, bro, 50 is gonna be there and you're gonna owe him money. You're gonna owe him money.
I feel like I owe him and I don't even know him.
Rolled on the go. Rerolled that on the go. Shit. But a name. Okay, and also let me just say this. Let's get Ja Rule his fucking credit. Because everybody in this motherfucker, everybody in this fucking studio was a motherfucking Ja Rule fan. Fuck that. Bro, everybody in the studio was a Ja Rule fan. Period. Skrillex, you want a Ja Rule fan?
He had hits. On top of hits.
Okay.
On top of hits.
Okay.
He had hits with all your pop your favorite pop stars back in the day. The legends.
I'm gonna fuck you up though. What about the females, bro? Mm. Not females. What about the female MCs? Mm. Should we just say women MCs? Mm. Because I don't want to say I'm not saying females. Excuse I'm me. Saying
don't call the female them females.
Okay. So the women MCs.
The women MCs, baby.
Okay, the women MCs. Now, bro, you know if I could ask you to name 20 rappers, could we call them raptresses?
That'd be
a raptress.
It's super long. It's super long.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Raptress.
That's a rap. That's a shit. No. Yeah, right. Multiple raptress eye.
the multiple raptress eye.
But no. Okay, so, bro, I scrolled in my phone, bro, and I saw this name, and I said, she don't get her credit. I could ask you to name me 5 female MCs that you think are dope. Let's do three. 3 female MCs, just name them. Just go off the cuff. It don't matter. Anybody you think is dope, you ever heard, you know, you're just like, oh yeah, MC Light and Queen Latifah and Nicki, all these people. Just go ahead.
Just off the top?
I know you probably got more than me. Go ahead. I heard some new shit recently too, bro. Bro, what was your name? Doja Cat.
Yeah, Doja Cat decent.
Bro, Doja Cat's hot.
Doja Cat hot.
And I
fuck with Tierra Whack. Cause she's super dope.
Come on, now we gonna put her in this. We gonna put her over this side. Cause she got that she legendary got that, shit, that legendary potential. Like, let's give her what it is. Okay.
And what's crazy?
Yep.
When y'all jump on the wave, it's gonna be too late.
Oh, it's gonna be too late. It's gonna be way. It's already kind of too late.
It's already. Been late. I mean, Shorty been high for like 2 or 3
are
years
you fucking
anyway.
Kidding me, bro?
If not, excuse me if I got it wrong.
Maybe
it might
longer.
It may be longer. I'm just not getting away.
She watching right now, like up, they sleep.
Yep.
But sorry. Cause you're shorty, you're dope.
You're dope.
Now.
Somebody maybe hit my bitch.
So now let me ask you this. So if you gotta do 3, you say Tierra Whack.
Okay. Doja Cat.
You fuck with Doja Cat, okay.
Yeah. And we talking like
I'm talking about all female MCs. I know it's too many to name, and I know you're trying to go.
It really
more recent,
is because it's just like recent, I'm trying to do more recent and just like
okay, give me a legend. Just give me a legend. It don't matter who it is. A legend. Even if she a newer legend, just give me a legend.
We'll say Nicki, because she a legend.
I was finna say, you better.
She a legend. I'm not going to lie to you. No, I'm not going to hold now, you. Nicki's a legend.
Now, old school shit, we know that shit like the back of our hand, like I said.
Oh, yeah.
Like Queen Latifah. It's so many to name that we're going to put them in their own category like Tierra Whack. So we're talking about MCs that bring that shit. Just right. Just we just throwing them out. We're not. We don't want to add everybody's legendary status and try to make that a part of the. Because in that case, we would have no new people. Because all the legends would over if we do it like that. So we just gonna do these quick 3. Now you know what's crazy, bro. Why does no one ever put Eve in their top rappers, bro?
And ain't gonna lie to
for
you,
women,
bro.
That
is fucking wild, bro. And then you know what's so crazy, bro. I apologize, Eve.
Come on, man.
I apologize.
Shorty got Billboard hits.
Yes. And she done gave songs away.
Gave?
She done gave hits away.
To men. So, I say that to say this.
We're going to give her motherfucking flowers. Why she alive right
Skrilla
now?
Raise
baby.
That glass up. Look, Skrilla, I see you back there partying. They will wait.
He's going. If y'all can see this, ooh-wee. He out here wilding. Okay, yeah, take a shit forward.
Excuse me. I don't want no problem.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Yes, sir.
And I want to give y'all so much more. But what we going to do, because we already know, we got to leave the fam, man. We got to leave the fam. You know when you at your cousin's house and you don't want to leave?
Ma, can I stay an extra night? Grandma said it was okay.
Grandma said it was cool.
You know you
got
to go to school. Who going to take you to school tomorrow?
Who going to take you to school? It's Sunday. I mean, well, today is not Sunday, but in the scenario, it is.
It's Sunday.
You're going to school tomorrow, and you don't live on that side of town. Who's going to take you? Grandma can't drive. Your aunt can't drive. So we got to go. We got to go. But we'll be back.
Ooh, we will be back.
Ain't no way around it.
We'll be back, bro.
This the family.
We will be back.
So with that being said, thank y'all, man, for bringing in our first episode. The first official episode, man.
Let's get a round of applause for that.
The first
episode.
Make some noise.
This
the
is.
The first official episode. Come on, give it to him, brother.
Man, this is Flip Flops and Socks. I am Tashambi.
And I'm your boy, Paris, man. And we out.
Yes, sir.
Appreciate y'all.